curious if you listen to any audiobooks, maybe I don't really
know. Tell us a story, Dad.
Thank you.
This is hiking. If you've never been on a hike, this is how super safe it is. This is sage. When you see it, pick it up and give it a sniff. It'll calm you down, give you energy. The reason why calming yourself down gives you energy is because when you're not calm, that tightens up all your muscles and uses up your energy on bullcrap, like tight muscles for no reason. So good. So, give it a sniff when you see it. The reason why you want to do this is because you're a product of nature, and coming out here, not only is exercise, it's very clearing to your energy field. Whether you want to think of it as a physical, I have energy, or a vibrational energy. Hello.
Hello.
So, when you come out here, the ideal is to come alone. Because when there's another person, there's pressures to impress, pressures to caregive, be considerate of, all that kind of stuff. Takes away a layer of the benefit. I've never had one single terrible thing happen to me. And I've hiked hundreds of miles. Not by an animal, not by a human. You hear horror stories on the news of people getting lost. You'd have to be a friggin' idiot. Like, stay on the trail. You see how defined the trail is, right? So, you know, I might go off the trail a tiny bit here and there, do a little exploration, but I know exactly how far I'm going. I don't go too far. Not about that. I just want to come out here safely and get home safely and get my benefit from it. So, just stay on the trails. There's so many great trails now. For, I don't know how long these have been here, but they're here now. They're pretty dang defined. And there's signs. Keep your track. Keep you on track. So, if you can, go hiking. If you can't, then watch this video. Go hiking with me. And maybe you're paralyzed, or maybe you're bedridden for whatever other reasons. I've basically been that sick before. It's horrible. And I have total compassion and understanding. So, I know you can heal whether you're paralyzed or not, to the point where you can come out here by yourself. However, until then, I'll go with you in this video. And if it occurs to me to others, I will. But I think it might be a good idea if it's interesting to people to have this be a little bit of availability to you, getting the first little bits of nature back into your life. If you're really super sick and are paralyzed to the point where you can't come out to these areas, the first step to healing is dreaming, envisioning, and you know, if you can really allow yourself to just truly dream and enjoy the dream of you, say, walking again, and just feel the fullness of what that really feels like in your dream, then that's a vital, important step to it possibly becoming real. And the people that end up having these miraculous healing stories are the people that didn't believe the DRs when they said, "You'll never walk again." They're like, "Yeah, F you, I'm walking again." And they end up walking again. Why? Well, they just decided they're not going to believe them. You can decide not to believe them. They're just making up stuff. They're not gods. A lot of them look pretty ding-dongy humans. So, okay, you memorize a bunch of stuff and you went through medical school and now you regurgitate the pharmaceutical company's stuff. Because that's what they're implementing, and so that's what they're learning, and that's who's teaching them. Doesn't really take a smart person to do that. It takes somebody that has the ability to memorize and retain information and follow orders and not think for themselves. Because the ones that end up thinking for themselves end up not doing that crap. At least not to themselves. And they end up going other routes for their own personal selves and their own families. But they gotta, you know, pay that huge loan, so they're gonna sell it to you. They're gonna tell you crap, it's gonna keep coming. Pretty gross, but they justify it. They say that that's what you all want. That, you know, try to tell people to change their diet and move more, do this, do that. They don't want it, they just want a pill. Okay, well, for those who it's, that's true for, go to the DR, they'll give you pills. But for those who want more, there's other options. Yeah. Really, really good viable options. That, yeah, of course they work. Or those of us who do it wouldn't be doing it. We're not idiots. I'm not going to sit here and be doing stuff for... Oh, freaking snake, how cool. It's a tiny snake, it's like gardener snake. Wow, okay. That's awesome. Can't see it in the video or show you. Anyways, TMI on that, but you can heal from everything and anything. Your body is making and regenerating new cells every single day, period. But if you're not providing the building blocks, then what is your body supposed to do with crap? She can make more crap. So on my website, and I'm sure in videos from time to time, I'll cover what the building blocks are. They're super simple. But one of the building blocks is getting all over body sun. You know, your bones and your ligaments, your joints, your teeth need what the sun provides in order for them to be strong and heal and maintain health. Oh, and how many people are laying outside naked every day? Yeah, exactly. Practically zero. I don't even do it every day. I can't lay out naked because of my current living situation with roommates. But get a bikini on, get a Speedo on, get as naked as you possibly can and go lay on the sun. And go hiking if you can. If you're paralyzed, get those people that love you, take you outside, take your freaking clothes off, and lay in the sun. I have a blog about how to do that correctly, because we are all different skin types, so we require different amounts of sun. And to overdo anything is not wise. It's not healthy. It doesn't matter if it's a natural thing. You overdo it, you're going to damage things. So go out and get in the sun in your yard as naked as you possibly can and watch these videos. Envision yourself walking. Okay? And watch my future videos so you can know what else is involved. It's not complicated, it's like freaking simple and super cheap, basically free. But there's a few layers, so we can't get into all of those layers right now. basically what I wanted to cover. It's just show what hiking is, show that it's safe, and give those the opportunity to come hike with me who can't go on their own. So peace out. I share because I love Yarrow. This plant saved my son's life. It's important. Beautiful ally and friend. Have a good day. Mwah.